einmal für Alumni TV und ich bin hier am Stand von Misa und habe ein doch sehr abgefahrenes Instrument auf meinem Schoß. Und zwar ist es die Kitarra. Es ist called Kitarra, isn't it?
Yeah.
Und das Besondere daran ist, es ist eine komplett digitale E-Gitarre ohne Saiten, besteht eigentlich nur aus Knöpfen und hat hier ein Touchscreen. Und vielleicht kann man das ganz kurz mal einfangen. Ich habe hier die Möglichkeit, über das Touchscreen verschiedene Sachen einzustellen. Ich kann über die Konfiguration gehen, mir verschiedene Presets aussuchen, beispielsweise jetzt hier eine verschiedene E-Gitarren-Sounds. Die suche ich mir aus. Schließe das Ganze, hänge mir das Ding um und kann dann beispielsweise über den Touchscreen hier, das ist ein bisschen schwierig, ja, ist ein bisschen gewöhnungsbedürftig, aber man bekommt auf jeden Fall einen Haufen wahnsinniger Sounds raus. Man kann sich beispielsweise auch über das Touchscreen hier auch die Saiten anzeigen lassen. Das heißt, ich könnte das Ganze auch so spielen. Es ist ein bisschen ungewohnt, weil man halt nicht den Fingernagel benutzen kann, sondern wie man es von einem iPad beispielsweise auch kennt, wirklich die Fingerspitze benutzen muss. Neben mir sitzt Jeff. Hi Jeff.
Hey man, how are you buddy? Hey everybody.
Und Jeff ist hier von der Firma Misa und hat uns bestimmt ein paar Sachen noch darüber hinaus zu erzählen. Jeff,
yes,
this is kind of an extraordinary instrument.
It's really completely a whole new instrument. I like to kind of think of it as how a piano became a keyboard. When keyboards first came out, people were like, well, why would you want to make all those weird sounds with this thing? We have a piano already. It's kind of the same thing. We're not here to change the guitar at all. We're here to make guitar players kind of be able to play more like keyboard or synth players or digital music. When we hear digital music, bands like Daft Punk and all these different bands that are doing that, there's no way that can be replicated on a normal instrument. So we decide, all right, let's take a guitar-based concept and make music that is so far out and different sounds, different presets and stuff that's completely programmable by the user. Right now we only have 12 basic sounds inside of this because it's the prototype, but literally there'll be hundreds in here when it's available in July. And every user that uses it, no two people will sound the same. That's what's cool about it. Everybody that uses it, you can go in and you can change the parameters of every different thing inside of here. If I go inside of this, I can change the distortions, the modulations, the delays, and then just save it in, and it's in there, and that's my preset, you know, and it's all set inside of there. So everybody will sound different. And with the USB and MIDI, you can load in your own sounds or go on misadigital.com and download the different downloads. I'm a professional musician, that's what I do for a living. I play all over the world for different artists. And for me, this has really opened up a whole new world of not only recording, but also even live performance capabilities, because the sounds that are coming out of it, when you hear it, you're like, whoa, where did that come from? It's not a guitar, it's not a keyboard, it's something wild maybe that a mod came up with, I don't know. But somehow it just sounds really cool, and that's the
guitar. All right, cool. So it's not only an interface, it's a synthesizer or a sample player, or how does it work?
Absolutely, it's all of the above. It has USB and MIDI, so you can sample any type of, you know, normal, you know, MIDI controller that you want. You can control anything with it. But really the most genuine thing about it is all the sounds are internal. Okay? So if I went into my presets and just brought up let's say a pad sustain, okay? That's a program that I put in there that is a electric guitar along with a keyboard pad. Okay? So normally to be able to play just this patch, you would have had to have two keyboards, a pitch bend, and an electric guitar. Okay?
Right.
What I do now is I just control it with playing a chord here and then control it with the hands. Would you like to hear it? You wanna hear it? You wanna hear
it? Okay.
Go ahead. If I play a chord, I control it with my right hand. And where I play on the screen, I get different synths. That was all done just by playing one chord, but literally to be able to play that, you would have had to have two keyboards, a pitch bend, and an electric guitar to really even be able to make that sound. And the cool thing is, by touching different places on the screen, the way that you set it up, you can have complete control over the preset that you're playing in.
Okay, so it's actually not made for rock music, but more like for...
Oh, absolutely
for...
it is.
Yeah?
So let's say we wanted to play like some rock and roll guitar, right?
Yeah.
We go into like an electric guitar patch, bring up our distortions, and let it rip. By controlling the screen, I'm actually doing like a whammy bar. control here. Okay, and then anything you want to play, you can play with the left hand, rather than distorted chords. Or just like a regular scale.
Okay.
And no latency. Normally with a digital instrument, you'd have a lot of latency or lag time or delay because it wouldn't track correctly.
Yeah.
With this, there's none.
All right.
It's right on. Whatever you play, you hear.
Okay.
So it's really cool.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, Jeff.
You got it. A mod even sounds good on, so you know it's got to be good, right? One more important thing. €959 retail price. Very inexpensive. Even me and a mod can afford it.
950, also 995 Euro. Und ja, also... Es ist auf jeden Fall für die experimentelle Musik, ich sehe vor allem da auch die Zukunft der elektronischen Musik, es ist auf jeden Fall eine spannende, interessante Sache. Und mal schauen, was daraus so geht. Vielen Dank. Thank you.
All right.